I had just turned 13 when the film Inside Out was released in theaters. Growing up, Pixar films seemed to always be in rotation at my house, Nemo, Monsters, Inc., and The Incredibles being some of the favorites. For my entire generation, Pixar films spanned our adolescence and imprinted upon our minds. Pixar Animation Studios is renowned for creating films that are not just visually stunning, but also emotionally resonant. The studio has tackled a range of themes in their films, but one that stands out is the exploration of emotions. While Pixar may be known for their nuanced films, it was Pete Docter, the current chief creative officer at Pixar, who brought a new emphasis to emotional storytelling. This video will focus on three of Docter's films: Up, Inside Out, and Soul. Each movie explores emotions in a unique way, from the grief and loss of Up to the complexity of the human mind in Inside Out, and the exploration of the meaning of life and soul. By examining these films, we can gain a deeper understanding of not only Pixar's method, but of how our emotions influence our own lives.
And the winner is... Up. Peter Docter.
Pete Docter joined Pixar at the age of 21 in 1990, when the studio was still selling software, but went on to work on several of the studio's early films, including Toy Story, A Bug's Life, and Toy Story 2. Docter's gone on to direct some of Pixar's most beloved films, including Monsters, Inc., Up, and Inside Out. His work is often characterized by his ability to create complex, emotionally resonant stories that appeal to both children and adults. He's won numerous awards for his work, including 3 Academy Awards, and is widely regarded as one of the most influential and innovative figures in the animation industry. While for many directors, a film like Monsters, Inc. would have been a career peak, for Docter, it was only the beginning. Since his first film, Docter's pushed the boundaries of what is possible in the realm of animation, exploring more and more complex themes and subject matter. While there aren't many auteurs in the animation industry, Docter's ability to draw from his personal life experiences and dedicate his entire life to his craft has made him one of them. While other animation studios may look for content elsewhere and hire external directors, Pixar works entirely from within. The writing, animation, and directing is solely completed by the creative team at Pixar. They hire only the best and deliver only the highest quality content. Pixar's Up explores the themes of grief and loss. The movie follows the story of Carl Fredrickson, an old man who's lost himself in grief over the passing of his wife. In the beginning of the film, we see Carl's life play out before us in the sequence Married Life. From Carl and Ellie's first meeting as children to their marriage, through the ups and downs of their life together, and finally to Ellie's passing, the montage is a poignant depiction of the beauty and fragility of life and love, and it sets the stage for the rest of the film. Up is a testimony to the bravery of Pixar, a studio capable of putting audiences through intense emotional turmoil only to take them on a journey to South America with an old man in his floating house. Pixar's ability to bring humor and heart into their films is unmatched in the world of animation, and is the reason they are the industry standard. In an interview with Harvard Business Review, Edwin Catmull, the co-founder of Pixar and former president of Walt Disney Animation Studios, stated that, "If you give a good idea to a mediocre team, they'll screw it up. But if you give a mediocre idea to a great team, they'll make it work." Pixar only hires the best of the best, a practice that has kept them in the top of their field. Through its beautifully crafted storytelling and emotional depth, Up captures a universal experience of loss and the importance of cherishing the memories and relationships that give our lives meaning.
The Ellie Badge.
Wow.
Pixar's Inside Out delves into the complex world of emotions. The film tells the story of an 11-year-old girl named Riley and her 5 core emotions, joy, sadness, fear, anger, and disgust, who live in her mind and control her actions. Throughout the film, we see Riley's emotions struggle to adapt to her family's move from Minnesota to San Francisco. Joy, the leader of Riley's emotions, tries to keep her happy and positive, but the character of sadness proves to be an essential part of Riley's emotional journey. As Riley's life becomes more challenging, sadness becomes more prominent, eventually leading to a moment where she touches one of Riley's happy memories, turning it into a sad one. This event sets off a chain reaction of events, ultimately leading to a crisis point where Riley considers running away from home. The portrayal of depression in Inside Out is subtle but powerful. It shows that sadness and other negative emotions are a natural and necessary part of the human experience. It also emphasizes the importance of allowing ourselves to feel our emotions fully and process them in a healthy way. Pete Docter, in fact, wrote Inside Out from personal experience. In an interview with NPR, he revealed some of his childhood trauma that inspired him.
Personally, when I was in fifth grade, so about 11, my folks moved us to Denmark. And so not only did I have all new friends and all new surroundings, I didn't even understand what they were talking about, which was very difficult.
It's the personal experience Pixar delivers that sets them apart from the competition. Inside Out encourages viewers to embrace all their emotions, not just the positive ones, and to recognize the importance of emotional awareness and self-reflection in our daily lives. The film offers an essential message of hope and understanding, reminding us that it's okay to feel sad sometimes, and that seeking help and support from those around us can make all the difference in our emotional well-being.
I miss home. I miss Minnesota. You need me to be happy, but I want my old friends and my hockey team. I want to go home. Please don't be mad.
Oh, sweetie.
We're not mad. You know what? I miss Minnesota too. I miss the woods where we took hikes.
And the backyard where you used to play.
Spring Lake, where you learned to skate. Come here.
Pixar's Soul is a thought-provoking film that explores the concept of purpose and what it means to be alive. The film follows the story of Joe Gardner, a middle school teacher who dreams of becoming a jazz musician. However, when he finally gets his big break, he falls into an open manhole and finds himself in a strange world between life and death. Joe must navigate the mysterious realm of the great before, where new souls are formed and given their personalities before being sent to Earth. There, he meets 22, a soul that has yet to find its spark and purpose. Together, they embark on a journey of self-discovery and learn the value of appreciating the simple moments in life. As the story unfolds, the film explores the concept of the afterlife and the meaning of existence. Through Joe's journey, the movie examines the question of why we are alive and what our purpose is in this life. It suggests that our purpose may not be tied to our passions or careers, but rather in the simple moments of everyday life, such as spending time with loved ones or enjoying the beauty of nature. Most of the film, Joe believes he was meant to be a jazz musician, and how it's his big break to play alongside Dorothea Williams. While Joe does succeed at accomplishing his goal and securing the gig, Bud is disappointed when he walks out at the end and is left feeling unsatisfied.
What's wrong, Teach?
It's just, I've been waiting on this day for my entire life. I thought I'd feel different.
I heard this story about a fish. He swims up to this older fish and says, I'm trying to find this thing they call the ocean. The ocean, says the older fish, that's what you're in right now. This, says the young fish, this is water. What I want is the ocean.
As a fish, Joe struggles to swim and breathe, and he realizes that he needs to learn to let go and trust his instincts to survive. He eventually does this and finds himself swimming effortlessly with the fish, in a state of pure joy and contentment. This experience represents Joe's realization that he has been too focused on achieving his goals, and has forgotten to enjoy the journey. Pixar Animation Studios, under the direction of Pete Docter, have produced films that tackle complex issues, especially those relating to emotions. The films Up, Inside Out, and Soul provide important lessons for young and old audiences alike. Through these films, Pete Docter and Pixar have brought emotions to life on the big screen, providing a deeper understanding of how they influence our lives.